everybody. With you from NFL Live, Mike Tannenbaum, Victor Cruz, Diana Rossini. I'm Wendy Nix. It is now July, which is also the month that training camp begins. So as we do a deep dive into respective divisions, today we look at the NFC North. Four teams, some really compelling storylines in this division, Diana, but one has to stand out for you. What is it?
For me, it's the Green Bay Packers. It's how's this marriage between first-year head coach Matt LaFleur and Aaron Rodgers actually going to work? I kind of look at it as the equivalent to giving your teenager the keys to a Ferrari. That's how I look at Aaron Rodgers, obviously a future Hall of Famer. He's got all this veteran leadership ability and experience. How is a first-time head coach going to make that work? And is it going to work? So I'm going to definitely be keeping my eyes on Green Bay.
Yeah, I'm going with the Chicago Bears. Obviously, looking at that defense, can they continue to be that dominant year in and year out? Can they be consistent on the defensive side of the ball? And obviously on the offensive side is Mitchell Trubisky. Can he take that next step in the maturation process and be that consistent quarterback that they want him to be for years to come down there in Chicago? Because those fans, I know those fans, and they're banking on it.
And for me, it's the Minnesota Vikings and Kevin Stefanski, their offensive coordinator. Last year, Coach Zimmer had John DeFilippo. It wasn't a good match for a number of reasons. Kevin Stefanski came in halfway through the year. We saw an improvement in the Viking offense. Now they have a whole offseason to work with Kirk Cousins, hopefully a healthy Dalvin Cook. How does that all come together? I think if they're more of a run-first team with some play action, that's going to help their offense and keep that defense off the field. I think a full season with Stefanski can make a big difference for the Vikings.
Are you confident, Mike, that Kirk Cousins was the right decision for the Minnesota Vikings?
Well, I think it from a standpoint of he was the best available. And from a front office perspective, sometimes it's not ideal, you know, but they improved their quarterback position. You could say that they overpaid. But Kirk Cousins is a winning quarterback. He was their best option. Now what Mike Zimmer's trying to do is say, now that we have Kirk Cousins, what's the best way we could put him in a position to be successful?
And having Dalvin Cook definitely helps them. It helps them be balanced. It's not just Kirk Cousins dropping back and throwing to Thielen and all those great receivers, but he has some balance with the running game. And if Dalvin Cook could be any shadow of what he was before he got hurt, they'll be in good shape.
I'll ask each of you who you think wins this division, but before I do, which of these teams has the most to prove, you think, in 2019?
I'm going to go with my original answer of the team that I'm actually most interested in, which is the Green Bay Packers, knowing that how much change they've gone through. The organization clearly said, we are picking our quarterback. We're not going to stick with the coach, getting rid of Mike McCarthy, of course. So I think in terms of proving that they made the right decision to get rid of Mike McCarthy and also putting that confidence that Aaron Rodgers is the Aaron Rodgers we all know he can be.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think Aaron Rodgers, he should feel like a little bit of rejuvenation right now.
Yeah,
getting a new coach, a new kind of circumstance around him, obviously some new weapons and stuff on the outside or some new familiar weapons that he's had that are going to be expected to do more this year. But I think he should feel good about where he is and where he is in his career and kind of getting this new group of receivers, a new group of offense, including the head coach, and bringing them with him to where, you know, where he feels like he is in his career.
You know, for me, it's Matt Patricia. Matt Patricia left the New England Patriots. He has an incredible reputation, really bright guy, really relates well to players. I thought he was a guy that was going to step out of Coach Belichick's shadow and really just become one of these frontline head coaches. Things didn't go ideal, but I think he has a chance to be reflective of last year. And I think Detroit has a chance to surprise teams. It's a very talented and deep division. But I've always been a big believer in Matt Patricia, and I think Detroit will surprise teams this year.
They, too, have a very solid quarterback. They've got their guy, and they've built around that. All right, quickly, a division winner.
I'm going to go the Chicago Bears.
Okay.
And then they got
Trubisky. Smart, Diane. I'm going Chicago as well.
Clean sweep?
Yeah, clean sweep.
It's a clean sweep for the Chicago Bears. All right.
See if they can do without Fangio.
We shall see. Catch us on NFL Live every weekday, 1:30 Eastern.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.